This is my rock. This rock took me to the university. This rock was the change of course of my life. What is your rock? Is your rock leading you to your goal? My names are Peninah, Nthenya, Musyimi. I grew up in Mathare slums, one of Africa's poorest slums, in a very poor family that could not afford 3 meals in a day. Imagine staying for 3 days without meal, and you're not sure if you're not going to get meal in the 4th day. I did survive that, not because I was so strong, but because at 10 years, I started dreaming big, dreaming of 3 meals in a day, dreaming of a nice bed. We used to sleep on the floor, dreaming of proper toilets. We used to shit on polythene bags and throw across the roof. That is commonly referred to as flying toilets in the slums. The environment was so safe and safe for anyone to grow in. If you grew up in such circumstances, who should be the change to your situation? I am the change to my situation. A priest in our church kept on saying, when you go to school, you get nice clothes, get food, get a nice car, get a bicycle. And I actually wanted to get that. So I told him, please, can you take me to school? I want to get these things I don't have. He did take me to school. Surprisingly, I didn't find all those things I had, nice clothes, you know, nice food. And that is when I realized it was a process. So you had to go through primary education, secondary education, go to university, eventually get a job, and finally buy these things for yourself. I asked myself, what do I do? If you want something you've never had, you must be willing to do something you've never done. And so, I put all my energies in classwork because he had taken me to school. And with a small tin lamp that went off most of the times when I was almost finishing my homework, I started dreaming of my own light. I dreamt of having electricity in future. And I forgot all the reasons why something should not work and found one reason why it should. I passed so well in my primary school, my final year in class 8. I was number 17 in Nairobi in Mathare division. I was called to join a very nice secondary school, but I could not go to the school because of lack of school fees. A community chief volunteered to give me 2,000 Kenya shillings to pay for my school fees every term. That was the only money I had. 2,000 shillings is equivalent to 20 euros. And I thought, I need to get a school. So the school I got that I could pay 20 euros was 16 kilometers from our home. Thinking of bus fare was a nightmare. My parents could not afford. Thinking of asking neighbors for help, they had more problems than I had. But I thought, this is my life. I need to make a choice. So always go with the choice that scares you the most, because that is the choice that requires most from you. So I decided my feet should take me to the next step. And so I walked 16 kilometers every day in the morning. That meant waking up at 5 and walking 3 hours. Sometimes in the days when we didn't have food, it was so harsh on me. And when my strength was going down and I felt I could not move, I started dreaming of driving a nice car, riding a bicycle, staying in a different environment that has no such harshness. And when I was driving my own car, by the time I arrived at the traffic, I was already at the gate school. I also did do well in my secondary education because I was determined. My dream was to become a lawyer, represent the battered women in the slums because they had no one to represent them, and of course, change my life from the slums. I thought I was closer to my dream. And so I applied for a higher education loan board from university. I applied for bursary and I got it, but my parents had to pay 40,000 Kenya shillings to complete the school fees for university. I said, that is so huge. It took my breath away. But I kept on motivating myself. And I remembered that if you want something you've never had, you must be willing to do something that you've never done. And so I heard of basketball scholarship in the college. And the scholarship was due in 1 month. I had never heard about basketball. People don't play basketball in the slums. It's so expensive. There are only soccer pitches. People play with polythene balls. And so I asked, where is this basketball? And that was the only easiest option I could go for. Imagine looking for 40,000 in the slums. That is 400 euros. That was a big nightmare. And so I said, I have to give this basketball a shot. It was due in 1 month. So I went, I met coach, who is called Mosh, and he saw a dedicated girl who wanted to learn basketball. And so I put all my energies in basketball. I learned layups, I learned shooting 3-point, and I knew that I'll try in my trials. So during the day of the trials, I went at the back of the line. I was scared. I was like, I wanted to see all the moves before I went for my turn. Apparently, when my turn came, I didn't see the challenge. I only saw the 40,000 I was looking to complete my school fees. So I shot all the 3 points, 10 out of 10, all the free throws, 10 out of 10, and all the layups, 10 out of 10, and I got the scholarship. And that's how I was able to complete my university. And so these challenges were stepping stones towards my dream. So I did become a lawyer. I got the car I wanted. I got nice clothes because I was earning money. But I thought, I had a feeling that just representing individuals didn't have much impact to the women and girls in the slums. They needed more. So I went back to the Mathare slums, the place I knew so well, that had no safe space for a girl. I remembered all the time and energies I spent solving my problems to be where I was. And I started Safe Spaces Organization. Safe Spaces creates spaces for girls to come, talk about their issues, build their inner soul, and just envision the future they want for themselves and their community. Safe Spaces gives them a push. And once they get the push, they start walking. And once they start walking, they are on their feet. We have Florence. Florence is one of the beneficiaries of Safe Spaces program. She was married off at 15 years. She became a single mother at 17 years. I had to rescue her through talking to her dad over a few beers. I took her back to school, and now she's a peer educator and a mentor in Safe Spaces program. She looks and takes care of the other girls in the program. These girls play basketball also. I thought it was a great opportunity for them to get help to go to school. And the coach keeps saying, when these girls come to court, they bring something different. They jump high. They score higher. And when the tough gets going, they are resilient. They are the change for their lives. When I started Safe Spaces 6 years ago, few girls, like 3 out of 10, were able to attend school. Now, 8 girls can finish school every year. 6 years ago, teenage pregnancies were almost like 7 out of 10. Now we have 1 or 2 pregnancies in the community. This is out of our work of reproductive health training and awareness for the girls. Now picture these girls, 1,200 girls who are beneficiaries, 8 to 18 years. They are the change to their community. They are the change for their lives. They are the ones who will bring the different power to the world to make it better. And do you know something? The basketball coach who gave me a push to go to the university is now my husband, and we have 3 children. What is your rock? Is your rock leading you to your goal? If not, then you need to do something that you've never done. Thank you.